This is the gateway to a grand past, to the Sri Padmanabha Swami Temple, which is located in Trivandrum. Now, while the main temple was constructed over 1,000 years ago, there were additions that were made by the Maharaja of Travancore in the late 18th century. Interestingly, this temple is still controlled by the Maharaja of Travancore and his family. The royal family here shares a very special relationship with the temple. It was built by the Maharaja of Travancore, Martand Varma, in the 18th century. A labor of love meant for successive generations of his family and, of course, his favorite deity. Today, any big event is incomplete till the royals seek the blessings of Sri Padmanabha Swami. We were lucky to get an appointment with the current Maharaja of Travancore, who's 87. He recounts the early days and shares some interesting, less known facts about the temple.
The Gopuram is not like this, but like this. And it is seven-storied. And it has taken 4,000 to 5,000 workmen on stone, working around the clock for 3 years to make this all this ready. And if you go to about 6 o'clock and you see this tower in silhouette, it looks like a boat. And in this part of the country, V-A-N-C-H-I, Vanchi, means a boat and a receptacle in which you put the offerings to the Lord. So every day when you see that, you're offering your heart and your soul to Him through this imaginary place of receiving your offerings.
It's bustling with activity as people from across the state come to pray at the Padmanabha Swami Temple dedicated to Lord Vishnu. In fact, the massive idol of the deity, which is reclining, measures 18 feet in length and is covered with gold and other precious stones. Adding to the grandeur, this reclining statue is unique in that different parts of Vishnu's idol, the face, the navel and the feet, are visible from three different door-like openings. From the middle opening, devotees are able to see the midsection of Lord Vishnu, and the first and last openings give a view of the face and the lotus feet of the Lord. Closely at the structure of the temple, you see that it's one of the few temples in Kerala built in the Dravidian style. It has a 100-foot tall, 7-tier gopuram or temple tower. Inside, there are 365 and a quarter granite pillars that are supposed to represent each day of the year, and each such intricate carving tells its own story. Now, if you're wondering what the rush behind me is all about, you can't enter this temple wearing trousers or a salwar or churidar. You have to wear either a dhoti or be in a sari. So I've just got myself this mundu and I'm going to wear this before I enter the temple.
Adding to the beauty of the temple are the rituals associated with it. The two annual festivals of the temple culminate in a grand procession in which the three deities, Sri Padmanabha, Narasimha Swami and Krishna, are carried on flower-decked elephants to a nearby beach for a grand ritual. During these festivals, the city is on vacation, celebrating.
Twice a year during the Utsavam, you have Kathakali performances, in fact, taking place on this platform, and people from across the state come here to be part of those festivities.
So that's how closely this temple is linked to daily life in Trivandrum. It's Kerala's pride, the royal family's pride, and carries a historic legacy, one that you can choose to vote for, giving it the status of one of India's seven wonders.